greet you in peace. My name is Kimmy Sung. Welcome to Black Vision, an art appreciation program. I've had a lifelong love affair with visual art, starting when I was a little girl growing up in New York City, where art was alive in the city. Galleries everywhere, easy access. I'd attend gallery openings, visit art museums anytime I wanted. And I even worked with an art firm in Soho when I was a teenager. And oh, how my appreciation for the visual art grew as my education about it grew. My appreciation for the people who create art has grown exponentially over time. And I'd love for yours too as well. Share with family, friends, colleagues, and especially the children. My hope is that they will gain an appreciation at a young age, just like I had the opportunity to. Art can change our world because you get to see what other people are thinking and feeling. It's just beautiful.
Abstract Expressionism is a style of art that evolved in the New York art community in the 1940s. Birthed from the European form of Expressionism, Abstract Expressionism is the predecessor of Surrealism. It evokes a combination of emotional intensity and rebelliousness. Merton Daniel Simpson, an African-American born on September 20, 1928 in Charleston, South Carolina. His father, Marion Simpson, was a water meter reader. His mother, Jenny Simpson, was a homemaker. Merton Daniel Simpson became not only a highly respected visual artist, he also became a well-known collector of African art. Young Merton suffered from diphtheria and rheumatic fever up until his preteen years. As a result, he spent most of his childhood in hospitals, and that is where he began to doodle and draw sketches. Starting at the age of 13, he became the mentee of artist William Haseley in South Carolina, who challenged the norms of the segregated South by bringing teenage Merton into the Gibbs Gallery to attend art classes. Merton Daniel Simpson's first solo show was held at the Charleston Museum, where, because of segregation, there had to be two receptions held, one for whites only, and one for whites who were open to attending with black people. He left South Carolina in 1949 to attend New York University by day and Cooper Union Art School by night, after becoming the first African American to receive a five-year fellowship from the Charleston Scientific and Cultural Education Fund. In 1951, Merton Daniel Simpson's work appeared at the Museum of Modern Art in New York City, in 1954 at the Guggenheim Museum, also in New York City, and in galleries throughout New York City and Washington, D.C. Later, he lived in Paris and traveled extensively throughout West Africa. He then returned to New York and opened the Merton D. Simpson Gallery of Oceanic and Contemporary Art. Daniel Merton Simpson passed away on March 9, 2013 in New York City. Thomas Seals, an African American, born August 20th, 1914, in Castalia, North Carolina. Thomas Seals was a self-taught artist who drew inspiration from the collection of abstract art of his wife, the mosaist Jean Raynal. He began exploring his artistic creativity in his 30s, working with materials found in his wife's studio. Seals used rags, velvet, oils, wood, house painter brushes, and canvases to create his work. His work embodied an unrestricted expression of intuition, and he is known for innovative abstraction and creations that embody emotional and physical feelings. Art, to Thomas Seals, was a form of expression for the dynamism that escapes form constraints. He traveled extensively throughout Mexico to study sculptures, frescoes, and architecture of the Chiapas and the Yucatan. Thomas Seals was also recognized as an advocate for African-American equality and representation in the world of abstract expressionism. He's had solo and group exhibitions in New York City, Cleveland, Ohio, Newport, Rhode Island, Los Angeles, California, Albany, New York, Ithaca, New York, and at the Herbert F. Johnson Museum of Art at Cornell University, Boston Museum of Fine Arts, Museum of the National Center of African American Artists in Boston, Massachusetts, Museum of Modern Art and the Whitney Museum in New York City, and also at the San Francisco Museum of Modern Art, among others. Between 1955 and 2010, over 30 museums have exhibited his art. Thomas Seals passed away on September 20th, 2000, in New York City. Thank you for tuning in, and remember, click subscribe at the end.